Okay, so today's topic of discussion is the carbocations, the types of carbocations, their formation and their stabilization. So in organic chemistry we will deal with carbocations very often in reactions like SN1 reactions, U1 reactions and many other types of reactions where carbocations are involved as the intermediates, reactive intermediates. So there are basically two types of carbocations based on the number of valence shell electrons in the central carbon atom. So the first type of carbocation is carbonium ion, so the central carbon atom possesses 6 electrons and so the octet configuration is not fulfilled, only 6 electrons are there, so it is in the sextet configuration. And the other type of carbocations is carbonium ions. This is a special type of carbocation. You will encounter this special type of carbocation very less often because the formation of this type of carbocation is consists of severe, very harsh reaction conditions. So we will also discuss that, the formation of carbonium ions. So first we have to understand their structures and their properties. So as we have discussed, the carbonium ions, which are very common in organic reactions, basically possess 6 electrons in the valence shell of the central carbon atom. So if you look at the sp2 hybridized, okay, so the central carbon atom is sp2 hybridized with a vacant p or vital, and if we consider the electronic configuration, this is the 3 sp2 hybrid orbitals of the carbon which are being utilized to form this 3 sigma bond, and this is the vacant p orbital. Its energy is very much higher than that of these 3 orbitals. I have just shown here for simplicity purpose. So this p orbital remain vacant, and also all the bonds involved here are 2-centered 2-electron bonds. What is 2-centered 2-electron bonds? Suppose you have a carbon-carbon single bond. There are 2 carbon atoms involved. So each carbon atom called one center. So there are 2 centers involved. So it is a 2-centered. And we know that all covalent bonds are composed of 2 bonding electrons. So there are 2 electrons. So this is a 2-centered 2-electron bond. Okay. And obviously the carbon atom is trivalent. The central carbon atom is trivalent. And the structure is trigonal, as you know. So this is the structural features of carbonium ions. So now we will consider the structural features of carbonium ions. Here the very structural conformation is very is actually not established very properly in case of carbonium ions, but it is believed that during the formation of carbonium ions, one CH bond is the bonding electron of one CH bond is shared by a proton in order to form this type of 3-centered bond. Here is the one center, here is one center, and here is one center. So total 3 atoms are connected with each other at the same time. So 3 centers are involved, and initially there was a CH bonding electron pair which is now shared by a proton in order to produce a 3-centered 2-electron bond. So 2 electron is utilized, shared by 3 centers or 3 atoms. So that's why it is called a 3-centered 2-electron bond. It is a common feature in all carbonium ions. Okay. And the most important thing is the octet is filled up. in case of carbonium ions, and that's why the onium term is here, and inium term is always will be applied to those carbon systems or those element where there is deficiency of electrons, as you know, carbene, nitrine. Okay, so oniums are the species where the octet rule is filled, fulfilled. And another important thing is, interesting thing is, there are no vacant vacant orbital, no vacant p orbital. Okay, so this is the this structure is basically in several literature reports as well as several textbooks, but recently the Clayden Warren, the authors which published the organic chemistry by Clayden Warren, in that book I have found this structure where the p orbital, the filled p orbital of the central carbon atom is bonded with two hydrogen atoms at the same time. This p orbital is filled and it is connected with two hydrogen atoms. The lower lobe is connected with the hydrogen atom and the upper lobe is connected with the another hydrogen atom. So here also, this is one center, this is another center, and this is the third center. So three centered, and also the two electron is shared between among these three centers. So this is also a three centered two electron bond. Okay, so obviously the pentavalent the carbon atom, the central carbon atom, is pentavalent. Okay, so basically these are the structural features of carbonium and carbonium ions. So now we will go into the formation of these ions. So first we will consider the formation of carbonium ions. Carbonium ions generally formed via two pathways. One is the removal of the leaving group. So this is a typical example of SN1 nucleophilic substitution unimolecular SN1 or E1. In any of the reaction, you can this substrate actually go via these both pathways and produces this intermediate. Then this will either be via SN1 pathway, this product will form, and if elimination reaction take place, then there will be this product. So this is a common intermediate for these two reaction pathways. Okay, so when a leaving group is removed from a substrate, this can be halide, tosylate, brosylate, mesylate. So when a leaving group is removed from a compound, then there is the formation of a carbonium ion. Here you can see the sextet condition is fulfilled. Another kind of pathway where the formation of carbonium ions take place is addition of electrophile. It can be H plus or any other electrophile. When these electrophiles are attacked by the unsaturated systems, here I have shown a double bond or an alkene compound. It can be any other unsaturated system. So after attacking this electrophile, this compound will produce this intermediate. Where you can see that the double bond is now there is no more double bond. One, this double bond is converted into a carbon, and the single covalent bond is formed between the carbon and the electrophile, incoming electrophile, and there is a formation of vacant p orbital. So this is also a carbonium ion. So these are the pathways where carbonium ions are formed. So one is removal of the leaving group, another one is attack by an electrophile towards the unsaturated compounds. Okay, so if we discuss the formation of carbonium ions, there are two types of carbonium ions. One is classical, and another is non-classical. The classical carbonium ion is basically the CH5 plus type of compounds. Okay, so this is the first example of formation of carbonium ions, where CH4 methane is being protonated by a super acid media. So what are the super acids? Super acids are those whose acidity is higher than that of the 100% sulfuric acid. So this is an example of super acid, this one. Another one is when hydrofluoric acid is mixed with antimony pentafluoride, it produces this one. This part is highly stable, so there is no more bonding between the F minus with this proton. So this proton is basically move around in the reaction media and look for the any electron cloud which it can attack. So this is a tremendous acidic medium. So when these type of super acids are made in contact with any types of substance, regardless of being pi electron cloud or sigma electron cloud, they just attack the center. So in this case, you have seen that the sigma electron bond, one CH sigma electron pair, is being attacked by the nascent H plus. And obviously, this type of structure it possesses, this CH5 plus. So this is a very unstable intermediate, and it decomposes to hydrogen and methyl cation. This methyl cation then reacts with three molecules of methane and releases three hydrogen molecules, and the tertiary butyl cation is formed, which is the most stable carbocation that can form in this situation. Okay, so the system is automatically converted into the most stable system, which is the tertiary butyl carbocation. Clear? Now we will discuss the non-classical carbonium ions. There are numerous examples of formation of non-classical carbonium ions. I will discuss only two, and in my next videos I will discuss the each type of reactions where the non-classical carbonium ions will form. So this is my start of discussion about the carbocations. So this video is basically the preliminary idea about the types of carbocations, their formation, their stabilization. In the next videos I will discuss each topic separately with detailed explanation and examples. Okay, so non-classical carbonium ions. The first common example of formation of these carbocations are the neighboring group participation by a carbon-carbon sigma bond. Okay, so what is neighboring group participation? I am assuming that you guys know what is neighboring group participation, because if I go to the discussion here about the neighboring group participation, then the video will be very long. So okay, I am giving one example. Suppose this molecule, if this molecule is subjected to solvolysis, then this type of intermediate is formed. Okay, first I am showing you the mechanism. The phenyl pi electron cloud helps to remove this acetate from this compound, and thereby this intermediate is being formed. Okay, so look very carefully, there is no pentavalency involved. This carbon is not pentavalent, so that's why this is not a carbonium ion, or okay, this is not a carbonium ion. So this is an example of neighboring group participation reaction. Okay, let me just clear this area. Okay, so now after you have an idea, a very little idea of about the neighboring group participation, now we will discuss this example. When this norbornyl brosylate, this is a norbornyl system and this is a brosylate group. So what is a brosylate group? This is a brosylate group, OBS. If this bromine is replaced by methyl, then it is called tosylate, TS, OTS. Okay. So when this norbornyl brosylate is subjected to acetolysis, so what is acetolysis? When the solvent molecule is acetic acid. So when this molecule is subjected to acetolysis, two molecules are formed, two product is formed, this one and this one. So how can we explain their formation? Because there is only one carbon atom which will undergo the substitution reaction. First we will think about that. The initial thought to our minds will come that there is only one reaction center, so only one product will form, but there the position is totally different. One is in one product the acetate group is attached with this carbon atom, in the other example the acetate is attached with this carbon atom. So what is the explanation of this observation? So let's discuss that. So first the brosylate group will be removed from the product. As you know, in the reaction of solvolysis reaction, that is in SN1 reaction, the formation of the carbocation is a redetermining step. So this is a redetermining step, and this is basically the step, the formation of carbocation is basically the step of the SN1 reaction in simple substrates like this. There is also the similar type of bond dissociation of the halide or any leaving group. Okay. So after this OBS group is removed, then this carbocation will form a vacant p orbital. So this is a classical carbonium ion. We are talking about non-classical carbonium ion, but this is an example of classical carbonium ion. So this classical carbonium ion will convert into non-classical carbonium ion in order to get stabilization. Look how this will going to be happen. So this bond, this carbon-carbon sigma bond, is in proper orientation or proper alignment with this vacant p orbital. Look, you all know the hyperconjugation, right? Where there is a vacant p orbital and a CH sigma bond. These two bonds are in perfect alignment. This is the homo of the CH bond and this is the vacant p orbital. So homo and vacant p orbital, the interaction will take place and the overall energy of this system will be reduced and the system will stabilize. So this is an example of hyperconjugation. Can you find the similarity in this case, in this situation also? This is the carbocation and here is the vacant. So here is the homo of the carbon-carbon sigma bond. Here you have encountered the homo of the carbon-hydrogen sigma bond, but in this case carbon-carbon sigma bond is involved. So obviously, in order to stabilize the overall system, this carbon-carbon sigma bond will undergo interaction between with this vacant p orbital. So this is the field carbon-carbon sigma bond homo. And this is a vacant p orbital, so these two orbitals will be interacted and the result will be this structure. This structure is called non-classical carbonium ion. Okay, Clear? So this is a classical example of formation of non-classical carbonium ion. So after that, as you guys have expected, the nucleophile, which is the acetate anion, will attack. Now is the interesting thing, which center will be attacked? This is an expected center. These all three centers are positively charged. So in the first thought, we will expect that this acetate anion can attack any of these three position, but no, this will attack only the tetravalent carbon center. Watch carefully. This carbon center already has two hydrogen atoms. From initial, this carbon center has two hydrogen atoms from the beginning. Here it also have two hydrogen atoms, and here also two hydrogen atoms. So what is the valency of this center? 1, 2, there is the carbon-carbon sigma bond, 3, and there is the two dashed bond. So overall, this is a pentavalent system. Pentavalent carbon center. So what is the valency of this carbon center? Here is only one hydrogen. So this is a carbon-hydrogen single bond. This is carbon-carbon single bond. So total two valency. Here a carbon-carbon single bond, 3. And this is the dashed one, so total 4. Here also one hydrogen atom is there, because the other valency was utilized by this OBS group. This OBS group is removed, so there is only one hydrogen. So this carbon hydrogen will provide one valency, this carbon carbon single bond will provide one valency, this carbon carbon bond will provide another valency, and this dashed one. So total 4 valency is there. So these two centers are 4 valence, but this is the pentavalent center. So the acetate cannot attack this center. Okay, for a SN2 reaction or for any nucleophilic substitution reaction, when the nucleophile attack, there must be a chance to overlap this nucleophile HOMO with the LUMO of the tetra-coordinated carbon that we have encountered in SN2 reaction, right? So the carbon center must be tetravalence. So this position and this position will be attacked by the OSE minus, and these two product will form. Okay, so I'm not going to the details of how after attacking this OAC minus, how the rearrangement, I mean the arrangement of this compound and the whole thing, I'm not going. If you guys are interested, you can ask me, then I will make a different video for that. Another pathway is the neighboring group participation by the pi bond. This is after the previous example, you can understand this very easily. So these two molecules are there. When they are subjected to solvolysis reaction, solvolysis means the solvent molecule will replace this tosylate group, the leaving group. So when these two molecules are subjected to solvolysis reaction, the reaction rate of this molecule, that is 1, is 10 to the power 11 times higher than that of 2. So what will be the reason? The reason is the neighboring group participation by pi electrons. So here is the OTS. So after the OTS is removed, this carbocation will form. This carbon center will contain now a vacant p orbital, and we know that this double bond is also composed of two p orbitals of two carbon atoms. So now there will be an interaction between these two system. One is the HOMO of this carbon double bond and this vacant p orbital. So this is the HOMO of pi bond, and this is the vacant p orbital. You guys know that. So this interaction is called HOMO conjugation or HOMO allelic conjugation. Okay, so this conjugation will essentially provide this structure. So this is obviously a non-classical carbonium ion. So then the solvent molecule will attack and the product will form. Okay, so these two are very classic examples of formation of non-classical carbonium ions. So now we will go into the stabilization of carbonium ions. See, why I am talking about only the stabilization of carbonium ions, not the carbonium ions, because during the stabilization of carbonium ions are formed. Here you have seen in this case, and also in this case, the first carbonium ions is, the first carbocation is classical carbonium ion. And then to provide stabilization, non-classical carbonium ion is forming. So carbonium ion is nothing but the stabilized form of classical carbonium ion. So that's why I am not giving the stabilization process for carbonium ions. So the stabilization is applicable only for carbonium ions. So there are six type of stabilizations. So first is hyperconjugation effect. I'm assuming that you guys know about this effect. Okay, one more thing. Each stabilization of carbonium ion, I will discuss each topic separately in six separate videos, because the topics are worth discussing in separate videos because they are so important. In this video, I'm just giving you a glimpse about the each stabilization processes. So the first is hyperconjugation effect. So what is hyperconjugation effect? They're basically a carbon hydrogen, the homo of a carbon hydrogen sigma bond will be in interaction with a vacant p orbital of a carbonium ion, and thereby providing the overall stabilization. So now you guys will ask how the stabilization is happening. So if you consider the MO diagram, so here will be the vacant p orbital and here will be the carbon hydrogen sigma bond. This is the sigma bond, the homo of the carbon hydrogen sigma bond, and this is the vacant p orbital. This will be highly stabilized than p orbital because here s character is involved. You all know that, right? So this will be the energy of p and p orbital, and this will be the energy of the homo of sigma CH bond. So after interaction, two molecular orbitals will form. Right. So now this pair of electron will go into this orbital, and this orbital will remain vacant. So if you consider the stabilization, how much stabilization is happened in this case? So you can clearly see that this much amount of energy will be released after the interaction. So the molecule will be, not molecule, the species or the intermediate will be stabilized, because initially the electron pair was in this position. After interaction, this electron pair comes down to a more stable molecular orbital, right? So the overall system will be stabilized. Like this, the number of hyperconjugable hydrogen atom is getting higher, then the stabilization will be the overall stabilization will be getting higher, right? So this is the hyperconjugation. The next effect is the electron donating resonance effect. You all know that the electron donating resonance effect are of two types. One where there is a pi electron system is donating the electrons by resonance effect to the vacant p orbital of a carbocation. Here is a classic benzyl cation. And another example is where the heteroatom, the lone pair containing heteroatoms like oxygen, nitrogen, they donate their non-bonding pair of electrons to the vacant p orbital of the adjacent carbocation. Okay. So there are two types of electron donating resonance effect. One is coming from the pi electron system, another is coming from the lone pair containing heteroatoms. Okay, so the next example is homoconjugation. You have just encountered the homoconjugation concept. Don't worry, I will discuss it in detail in another video with MO diagram and all those things. So here is just a glimpse. When there is a system like this, this is not an allylic system, because if this carbocation is in this position, then it will be allylic carbocation. Then there will be this type of stabilization, resonance stabilization. But this, there is no, in this scenario, there is no possibility of that type of resonance effect. So how this species is stabilized? This species will be stabilized like this. This center will contain a vacant p orbital, and this pi bond consists of two p orbitals. So this homo of the pi bond will now interact with this vacant p orbital. This is called homoconjugation, and the system will get little bit stabilization. So this is an example of carbocation carbonium stabilization. So the other examples are the non-classical interaction. We have just saw the non-classical interaction. So this is where the homo of the carbon-carbon single bond will undergo interaction with the vacant p orbital, and thereby this system will form. So this is the non-classical interaction and stabilization of carbonium. So this center is carbonium. This is the non-classical carbonium center. So after this this is the classical carbonium center. So after non-classical interaction with the homo of the carbon-carbon sigma bond, this non-classical carbonium ion will form. Okay. Another one is the bridging by the halogen atoms. This is a very common example. So recall the bromination reaction. In bromination reaction, you all know that this type of intermediate are formed. So basically what happened, there is a carbocation center. So this carbocation center is stabilized by the electron donation by this halogen atom. In this case, it is bromine. So this lone pair of electrons will be provided to the vacant p orbital by the halogen atom, and thereby the stabilization of the carbocation will take place. So why this halogen atom is giving this lone pair? Because right now this carbon center is containing the positive charge. So after giving the electron pair, this positive charge will be go into the on the halogen atom. Now halogen is more electronegative than carbon, then the overall system will be destabilized. So how this happens? See very carefully. In this case, this carbon center is in sextet, but after giving this lone pair, here this bromine atom is not in sextet. Here two electron, here two electron, here also two electron, here also two electron. So the overall 8 electrons are there. So octet is fulfilled in this scenario. So despite this positive charge on this more electronegative bromine atom, the system will be more stable because the octet rule is fulfilled here but not here. Okay, clear. And the last example is neighboring group participation. So you have just saw this neighboring group participation. I will make a complete video on neighboring group participation. So these are the very basic preliminary concepts about the carbocations, which are basically of two types, carbonium and carbonium. So their formation and their stabilization is are being discussed in this video. I hope you have learned something from this video, and I am able to deliver something useful to you guys. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe and share this video and like.